Scotty, what do you call cheese that doesn't belong to you?
I've got no idea.
Nacho cheese.
He's a dad, so we will let him get away with that one.
I'm going to do nachos, or my version of nachos.
Yep.
And everyone knows I love Mexico.
Yes.
But you've been to South Africa.
Yeah. Well, I've been to Mexico too, but yeah, South Africa. I've just got back not long ago, and it's such an incredible country. It really is. I think it's underrated in a lot of people's eyes. They're a bit worried about it, but it, seriously, took in so much great stuff and different foods and
cultures. That's what I was going to ask. Cuisine. What? Because it's so unknown to most Australians.
It probably is.
South African cuisine.
Yeah. Well, a lot of different stuff, because they've got, you know, that Dutch background, so there's a bit of that stuff happening. A lot of stews, big stews, and they love a barbecue. Briar, they call it a briar over there. So they'll fish briars, meat briars, and they'll cook up pretty much anything on the barbecue and then slab it around so the whole family can come in there and friends, and they just come in off the streets. And
it's, they're fans of meat, aren't they?
They love meat.
They love a bit of meat.
Which I was fine with. There's no problem there. Old Carney Scott, he was in pretty much heaven over there.
Beautiful. We're going to put some meat into ours as well. We're going to use a lamb mince, which most people wouldn't use for nachos. It's normally beef. We're going to do lamb. I love the extra flavour you get from lamb.
Yep.
So we're going to go lamb mince nachos, or if you're in Mexico, you would call them chilaquiles. First thing we're going to do is put our lamb in our fry pan. So minced lamb. Minced lamb's got a nice amount of fat into it, so you don't need to add any oil.
Okay.
You'll render a lot of fat out and you can cook in that fat. Nachos don't actually exist in Mexico.
I know.
Yeah, the closest thing is chilaquiles. And it's a breakfast dish. So chili con carne means chili, con with, carne meat, chili with meat. So that's what we're gonna make. We're gonna make a chili with meat.
Alrighty.
And our meat is lamb. So once that's cooked out, we get a bit of color on it. We're gonna add in, this is carne asada, which is just chili powder, salt, sugar, and paprika.
Pre-mixed for you.
Pre-mixed, ready to go. If you can't find carne asada, it's just one to one of those four things.
Okay.
So 1 teaspoon of chili powder or cayenne pepper, 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika, 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt. So once that's nice and brown, we'll add in that. Cumin, which is, for me, it's the smell of Mexico, that smell of cumin, that savoury sort of smell.
And realistically, if you don't put that into a Mexican dish, it just doesn't taste the same.
I grew up eating packet tacos, and it's that smell.
Yep.
Cumin is the driving force in a packet taco mix.
And the kids come home and they smell it too.
Oh, we're having Mexican taco night!
Yay! Beauty!
That's getting there, I reckon, mate. So we'll throw some garlic in. So just a couple of cloves of garlic, which we've diced up. We can throw our spices in now and cook them off. So there's our cumin and our carne asada. Then we're just gonna cook that down for 3 or 4 minutes until you start to get some real caramelly, colory bits on the lamb.
Uh-huh.
And then we'll add in our beans and our crushed tomatoes.
Okay.
That's coming along all right.
Yeah.
You can see how much of that fat is rendered out of the lamb.
Yeah.
So definitely do not add oil when you're cooking with lamb.
No, and then you're getting the real flavour of it. That.
Oh, yeah. Add in a pinch of salt.
Which is good fat, right?
Yeah, it's natural.
Yep.
Mostly, if it's natural, you're going to be okay most of the time. So we're throwing our beans now. Just red kidney beans. If you can get hold of pinto beans, black pinto beans, they're probably more traditional. The red kidney beans are fine. So our tin tomatoes. Add them in. I'm just going to cook that along now to develop the flavour. And I've only had a few South African dishes, but that looks like something they would eat in South Africa.
Yeah.
The stewy.
Yes, exactly, yeah. The whole stew thing is very big over there. Like you say, meat, fresh vegetables, and a lot of tomato-based things.
Yeah.
And I think,
I mean, and most cultures do this sort of thing where they'll have a tomato base, beans, meat. Everywhere you go has this really tasty, savoury version of something like this.
Yeah, and that's what I was going to say before. I don't know if it's the Afrikaans side of things or the Dutch or, you know, where it's come from, but it's definitely prevalent over there.
Yeah, the big melting pot. That's looking pretty good, mate.
Yeah.
So you've got a few options here. Most people at this point would put it into a bowl, put your corn chips on top, grate some cheese over the top and put it into your oven
for a little while,
and bake it.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it a little bit differently. I'm going to try and keep it fresher. So instead of baking it, we're just going to put, once we cook that down and we're happy with it, we'll put it into the bowl. We'll put our smashed avocado, our sour cream. I'm going to make up a little salsa to go on top of it.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll make it really fresh on top.
Yeah.
And we'll use the corn chips
Just a dip and...
It's a dip.
Yeah.
Yeah, so don't go soggy that
way. Sounds good. All
right, I'll get on to this salsa.
All right, mate.
So I'm going to take our tomatoes, just top and tail them. So I want to de-seed and dice. So the best way to do it is top and tail like that, run your knife in, and then if you pull, you'll expose what we call the heart of the tomato.
Yes.
And that's the best way to de-seed a tomato.
Okay.
And then you can just dice that flesh up.
See? I love it when I come here. Ben, you teach me something every time. The last time I de-seeded a tomato, I cut it into quarters and I got a spoon and scooped it out.
This way seems better.
That looks a little easier.
It's a lot easier.
And a little less time consuming.
It's amazing how quickly you figure things out when you're in a kitchen and you're doing 200 serves or something. It's like you need to de-seed 50 tomatoes.
Let's find a quicker way
of doing it. There's got to be a quicker way of doing this. And then I've got an onion, which we've just diced. Same sort of size that we diced the tomato up.
Yep.
So we'll pop that in there. Just a red onion. Garlic, clove of garlic, which we've diced up nice and fine. A little bit of lime juice.
Okay.
Just as our dressing. And then some coriander, which I'll just chop roughly. Now, you're not a big fan of coriander.
No, that's not my favourite in the world.
So the good thing is...
I can't stand it.
Yeah. So I won't put this on, mate. We can add it as we need it. So that's our little salsa, which we'll put on top. Keep things nice and fresh. We've got our smashed avocado, got our sour cream, and we're ready to go. Avocados, when you're buying them, when you're doing a smashed avocado, you want them to be soft.
Yeah.
So it needs to be almost black on the outside. And when you're feeling firmness, squeeze here, never here. Because there's a stone in the middle.
It's thinner there.
And it gives you a warp sensation.
Yeah, okay.
So if that's really soft at the top, and in the middle it's still quite firm.
I don't mind a warp sensation now and then. What? But that's just me.
Yeah, you grew up in a generation that a little bit different to mine, didn't you?
Yeah.
The warp sensation.
That's right. Back in the old days.
Pop that in there for me.
Yep.
So as I said, two options here. Put your corn chips on top if you want to. Grate some cheese over the top and put it in the oven. But I'm going to try and keep it nice and fresh. So we'll just move that out so it's nice and even. Get our smashed avocado and just place little blobs of it.
And that's just avocado, right? There's no extras, nothing added in.
And some citrus.
Some citrus, okay.
So it doesn't go brown.
Doesn't,
yep.
Yeah. Cool.
So that stops that
oxidation. And with that, does it matter if it's lemon or lime, or as long as it's
citrus? Doesn't matter, as long as it's acidic. So the acid stops the sugar oxidizing with the oxygen in the air.
Yep.
And that's what causes things to go brown. It's the metabolization of the oxygen. For the same thing.
Scientific.
It's my old life.
Well, did you teach science?
Yeah, I was a high school science teacher, mate.
Wow.
In my old life.
No wonder you're so intelligent. I loved my science teacher at school.
Yeah?
Yeah, he just let us sit up the back and not do anything.
That wasn't me.
I bet.
Then we've got our little salsa, which I'm going to have to put it on, Scotty, to show people how to do it.
No, of course you do. Right? Of course you do. Yeah.
Should have done a little bowl.
Don't worry, I'll find somewhere to get in there.
So then just grab your salsa, place that on top.
Oh, so you couldn't not do that, just on the encounter that I don't like coriander, please.
Got to make it look good.
Look at that.
And that's it. So that's our fresh version of nachos. And then you grab your corn chip. Get in there.
You go around the outside.
Yeah, stay away from the coriander.
Avoiding the coriander.
Right. You know what I need? There's cheese.
A little?
Just a little bit. Mm. That'll melt.
Understood.
So there we go. Fresh nachos from Mexico. Mm-hmm. But you're going to take this to South Africa.
Oh, yes. And you will love it.